द 100 ड्रेसेस पार्ट 1 अबाउट द ऑथर एल विसार एस्टर इज अ रिनाउंड अमेरिकन ऑथर एंड अ चिल्ड्रंस लाइब्रेरियन हर बुक्स वर प्राइमरीली बेस्ड ऑन हर लाइफ एक्सपीरियंसेस इन स्मॉल टाउन कनेक्टिकट इन अर्ली 1900 समरी इट वॉज मंडे वांडा वॉज एबसेंट Her absence wasn't noticed by anyone in the class. She used to sit in the room number 13 in the corner of the last row. Her seat was next to the rough boys who created lots of disturbance and never scored good marks in the class. Nobody exactly knew the reason why she sat there. In contrast to those boys, Wanda was a quiet and shy girl and nobody had heard her laugh. Sometimes she gave a crooked smile. Or maybe she lived in Boggins Height and her feet were always caked with dry mud. Her classmates never gave much attention to her presence once she occupied her seat. Mostly they noticed her outside the class during the noontime in the yard or on the way to school early in the morning. It was the time when groups of her classmates in 2 or 3 waited for Wanda to have fun with her. The following day, on Tuesday, she was still absent in the school and nobody was aware of her absence. But on Wednesday, Peggy and Maddie, the two best friends, were the first to notice her absence because Wanda had made them late to school. Both of them had been waiting for her on their walk to have fun with her. Peggy and Maddie were intelligent girls and sat in the first row with those students who got good marks in the exams. Peggy was very pretty, having curly hairs, and was the most popular girl in the school, belonging to a well-to-do family. Wanda was an American girl of Polish origin. Her name was unusual and difficult to pronounce in comparison to American names of her classmates. She didn't have any friends in the school and she always wore a same faded blue dress which was clean but never ironed. Many a time, Wanda was seen standing in the schoolyard watching little girls playing hopscotch. During these hours, Peggy would come and speak to her in most courteous manner. How many dresses did you say you have in your closet? A prompt answer came from Wanda, 100, all in silk and velvet, lined up in my closet. In the same manner, when someone asked about her shoes, she replied that she had 60 pairs of shoes in different colors, and then she walked away from there silently. Listening to her answers, the girls had a hearty laugh behind her back. This game of teasing was invented by Peggy. Though she was a kind-hearted girl and protected small children and animals being mistreated, still she never felt her act of bullying Wanda was cruel. The obvious lie spoken by Wanda became a silly game for Peggy and others, but Maddie, her best friend, felt bad and wished this game of teasing should be stopped. As Maddie was poor and she herself wore hand-me-down dresses, specially borrowed from Peggy, which were later mended by her mother to give those dresses a new look. Maddie often thought she was lucky that she didn't live in Boggins Heights, nor she had funny name as Wanda, and she was sensible enough not to speak a lie of claiming 100 dresses in her closet if anyone played the same game on her. Maddie wanted to stop this game of humiliation, so she sat down to write a note to Peggy but couldn't gather the courage to do so, in fear of becoming the next target of ridicule for Peggy and others. Besides, she was also afraid of losing a best friend. While thinking about Wanda and her dresses, she started wondering about who will be the winner of drawing contest, in which the boys were meant to draw motorboats and the girls were meant to design dresses. Everyone thought that Peggy would probably win the contest since she drew better than anyone in the class. She could copy and sketch any picture easily from a magazine. Next day it was drizzling. Peggy and Maddie didn't want to be late to the school as it was an important day for them. When they entered the classroom, they were surprised to see beautiful designs of dresses all over the room, almost 100 in number. As soon as the class assembled, Mrs. Mason announced the winner among the boys was Jack Biggles and among the girls was Wanda Petronsky. She had submitted 100 designs of dresses and the judges found all were worth winning first prize. Wanda was still absent in the class. She wasn't there to receive her applaud or prize. Peggy and Maddie were awe-stricken to see the beautiful designs of dresses. They admired the designs of blue and green dresses about which Wanda had told them earlier. In the end, we can say that humiliating or teasing others is a bad conduct. It not only lowers the self-esteem but also hurt and cause pain to the victim. Moral: take a stand against bullies.